Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will talk about lambda functions. Python supports lambda functions. A lambda function is a compact way of defining an anonymous function that is not bounded to an identifier. Let's see an example. This is a regular function f. It has two parameters, x and y. It returns the sum of x and y. When we call it using argument 1 and 2, the result is 3. We can implement this function using a lambda expression. It is equivalent to the following statement. F is a lambda function name. Lambda is a keyword. It is followed by two parameters, x and y. Next, there is a colon to separate the parameters and the body of the function. The body is just x plus y. That means it returns the sum of its two parameters. When we call it using arguments 1 and 2, the result is also 3. Note that the lambda function doesn't include an explicit return statement. However, it always returns the evaluated results of the expression. We can put a lambda expression as a part of a statement, and we don't have to give it to a function name. It is called an anonymous function. Here is an example. Let's define a function f. It has one parameter, n. It returns a lambda function. This lambda function doesn't have a name. It has one parameter, x. It returns x plus n, where n is passed from a caller. This lambda function is returned as a whole to the caller. So when we call this function f, with an argument n equals 10, it is equivalent to this statement. We are creating a lambda function named g. We can see from this output that g is actually a function. Now let's call this function g and pass an argument x equals 2. The return is 2 plus 10, which is 12. We can also get the same result by calling a function f with two sets of parentheses. N equals 10 and x equals 2. The result is still 12. This is equivalent to the following function h with two parameters, n and x. It returns x plus n. When we call this function h, we give it two parameters, n equals 10 and x equals 2. The result is still 12. Let's see another example. This lambda function determines whether a student's grade is pass or fail. It takes one parameter, x. If x is greater than or equal to 60, then it returns pass. Otherwise, it returns fail. When we call it using the argument x equals 95, the result is pass. When we call it using our argument x equals 45, the result is a fail. This lambda function is equivalent to the following function with an if-else statement. The lambda function just puts all these conditions check in one line. In this example, we use a lambda function to determine whether a student's grade is A, B, or C. It still takes just one parameter x. If x is between 90 and 100, the grade is an A. Otherwise, if the grade is between 80 and 90, the grade is B. If the grade is less than 80, the grade is C. We test it using x equals 95, the result is an A. We test it using x equals 85, the result is a B. We test it using x equals 45, the result is a C. This lambda function is equivalent to the following if-else statement. In the next example, the lambda expression is passed as an argument. This list, A, contains four strings with different length. A.sort is a list sorting method. The key parameter is a function it uses to do the comparison. We specify a key to sort the strings by length, from shortest to longest. This x will be replaced by every element in A, and the length function will return their length. The length are 3, 4, 1, and 2 respectively for these four strings. So based on their length, the sorted list is D, BB, CCC, and AAAA. This list B contains four integers, 1 through 4. We want to do the sorting in ascending order based on the absolute value of 6 minus each element. These values are 5, 4, 3, and 2 respectively. So based on these absolute values, the sorted list is 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, that was a brief introduction to Lambda functions. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.